And some of the research that we're actually doing now shows that we can alter that tumor such that it becomes appealing to the immune system. So we change the cold tumor, which is what in the immune world, people talk about a tumor that doesn't excite the immune system is cold, and a hot tumor is something that that invigorates the immune system. And so we're showing that we can do this now in colon cancer, and then we're moving on to even a brain cancer model.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Carman Giacomantonio. He is the Chief Medical Officer for Sona Nanotech. And Carman, good to see you. How are you?
Fine, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, excited to have you along a little bit more about what's going on within the company on sort of the medical side of things. And that's obviously what your specialty is. Tell me a little bit about targeted hyperthermia. This is what you're developing right now within the company and is super interesting. So tell me a little bit about what this means.
Yeah, sure. So targeted hyperthermia, well, hyperthermia, it strictly means raising the temperature of something, tissue in this, tumor tissue in this instance, to a targeted range. So we're looking for a range somewhere between 42 and 48 degrees, which is kind of like super high fever, but not the kind of temperature that would burn, you know? So it's a stress temperature, and it's targeted in that it's not only targeting the temperature range, but it's targeting where it's put. So rather than using hyperthermia as we do in operating rooms to heat a whole body or a whole abdomen, we're just trying to heat the tumor and the space it occupies to this temperature. And so we use our gold nanoparticles that are excited by near infrared light. So nanoparticles are just little rods, literally, that are 60 nanometers. And that's, you can only see it with an electron microscope, so tiny. And then these are, the tumor is infiltrated, is filled with these kind of rods. And then we pass almost like a flashlight, but it's near infrared light laser energy. So it's 850 nanometers, but it's kind of like just a red light that people actually have this kind of therapy in cosmetic clinics sometimes, a little less energy, but it's a similar principle. And that energy makes the particles vibrate. The particle change that light energy into heat. So that's essentially the
technology. Okay. And so you're targeted to treat cancer tumors. So explain to us the process of what you're going after with those cancer tumors, because as you mentioned, you're using those nanorods to put the light and the heat. So are you in essentially trying to get rid of the tumor? How does it work?
Yeah. So great question. So what we want to do, it's an evolutionary human physiologic process. And so we have fever to actually stimulate immune response. So what we're trying to do in the tumor is two things. One is we've exploited the knowledge that cancer cells, although we think of cancer as being this, you know, robust beast of tissue, cancer cells are actually quite fragile. And so they don't stress well. And if you heat them to that range, 42 to 48 degrees, the stress that they experience causes them to trigger many pathways of, say, death. Mm-hmm. So the cancer cells go into a death cycle, but the cells that support the cancer, the organ that they're growing in or the tissue that they're growing on, those tissues are actually resilient to that temperature. And so you create a stress only for the cells that are likely to die. And in the process, that whole process of the cell dying and the heat itself calls the immune system to action. So it comes to the site where the heat is, and it essentially cleans up the dying debris.
Okay, I know that the company recently had a peer-reviewed scientific journal article in Frontiers in Immunology that looked at breast cancer and melanoma. And so, first of all, getting it peer-reviewed obviously is a big thing for the company, but more importantly, what was in that article is substantial as well. So tell us a little bit about it.
Yeah, so we're very proud and excited. And so, peer review, Frontiers in Immunology, is kind of an industry standard of quality. So it's a rigorous assessment of what we've done. Essentially, the scientific methods that we've done in our lab to prove that what we just talked about, the heat will kill the tumor and not hurt the surrounding tissue and generate an immune response, that had to be, we submitted that for publication. And then Frontiers, of course, has a rigorous panel of reviewers that looks at what we do, and they actually call us out on things that don't make sense and make us explain it better. So what it gave us was a credible assessment of what we, validating the science, validating the process that we've invented was sufficient to prove our hypothesis that doing it to cancer will work. And then getting that published, there's an audience that's constantly combing these journals that see an opportunity. And that gets us in the room, in dialogue with other companies and other scientists that are thinking similar pathways, that opens up collaborations, it opens up opportunities for, obviously our goal is to treat cancers in humans. And so it opens up those discussions for us so that we have a viable solution to a problem that we're currently, which is.
Yeah, makes a lot of sense. For sure. So let's talk about where you are now. So obviously you've got some data that you're building off of, but take us to where you are now and really where you want to go for the rest of 2025. What are some of the things that you're looking at doing?
So we're continuing to expand into different tumors. So we're looking at colon cancer, which is really an exciting pathway for us. Colon cancers tend to be not immunogenic. There is a small percentage of them that are. But most of the colon cancers have not responded to the immune therapies. And some of the research that we're actually doing now shows that we can alter that tumor such that it becomes appealing to the immune system. So we change the cold tumor, which is what in the immune world, people talk about a tumor that doesn't excite the immune system is cold, and a hot tumor is something that invigorates the immune system. And so we're showing that we can do this now in colon cancer. And then we're moving on to even a brain cancer model that we're very excited about. So these are what we're doing right now is just broadening the horizon, because this is really a platform technology. And it's tumor agnostic. Doesn't matter what the name of the tumor is. It exploits a biological principle.
Well, we've all seen the amount of cancer rates that are rising really around the world. So obviously it's super important work. Doctor, thank you so much. Great to get an update on where the company's at and really where you want to go as well. And we look forward to following that story for sure. Thanks very much for your time. Appreciate it.
My pleasure. That's great.
Dr. Carman Giacomantonio, he is the Chief Medical Officer for Sona Nanotech.